My sister's daughter into my house? Are you mad? Don't you have respect again?
Nandeo. But now your niece must come out.
She must come out.
What happened? Now she must come out and wipe all the pictures of me she took. Huh? Now imagine.
She took your pictures.
A picture of me where I was squatting and shitting inside the bush.
Are you sure?
Let her come out now. Call her out first.
Chadika! 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 Come here. Come here, come and stand here. No, this is going to eat you.
What are you vibrating for? Okay, fine. Catch him. In my face. You want to beat her up? Huh?
Chadika, did you go into the bush today?
Answer me! Did you go that direction today? What did you go there to do?
I was strolling and taking pictures.
You are strolling and taking pictures. Does the pictures include his own?
I'm asking you!
Yes.
Now let's see. So it's true.
Now imagine.
It's okay. It's okay.
Imagine.
It's okay.
Yeah? She took the picture of me where I was just squatting and shitting inside the bush. Imagine when it's short.
Yeah, and your face was creased like that of a monkey. Very ugly.
Will you shut up? I'm talking about.
Come on, let me see. Bring the listen, let me see the pictures.
Now see now.
You really look bad.
Huh?
You really look so bad in the picture.
Now, is this what a girl like this should be doing to a man like me? And now, say, she has seen my shame now, and I demand to see her own. To appease me.
Appease you? You want her to strip naked? Is that what you are looking for? It's not going to happen.
She must go inside that bush and squat and shit. Then I'll watch. Everything I see is left my eyes.
She had to do that on gunpoint. Okay. Do you understand? Now come. Bring those pictures. Wipe out all those sins. The places that involve you. Wipe them out.
No tricks.
See the picture here. See our first option. See delete. I've deleted it. There's no picture.
Look for another one and delete all of them.
See, all the pictures are bush, bird. No, not
picture. Okay. I'm sorry. What's that your name again?
Abel.
Ah, well, that is so good now. Abel is supposed to be religious now. Your name is in the Bible. Say, who is in your walk? Don't fume like this. Eh? She has wiped off your destiny. Sorry for all the inconveniences.
Thank you, Nai. Thank you, Nai. See ya. Thank you, Uncle. Just that your uncle is the man we honor in this village. If not it, nothing will even stop me from making you to go naked.
Yeah, right. You think I'm scared? Maybe I need someone to strip me naked. After all, no one has done that in a long time. A real man though, not you.
You want to be stripped naked? Where is this one coming from? Now get me that camera.
No!
This is the
camera. I won't give you the camera.
What is wrong with you?
I won't give you the camera. This is the only thing I have here that helps me to chase away boredom from my sister. This village is so miserable and boring. I can't even have sex. All the men here smell of sweat and goats. Yuck!
Ah! Your mother did not do a good job on you. In fact, she did not do any job on you at all.
What is this addiction to sex?
Don't worry, I will marry you off to the nearest goat around. Or allow all the he-goats to book turn on you.
I want to go back to the city. I don't want to live in this village anymore. I can't stay here now. Stay with a man that farms and just rents one he-goat for a living. God forbid, I can't continue like that.
Chadika, I agree. I rent he-goat for good. It is not against the law. It is not a sin. I rent my he-goats to those who have female goats for them to cross and their female goats will get pregnant and have issues. And it's an improvement in the economy. What is a sin there? In your own case, you want to go to city. Not even to go and get pregnant there and get something good out of it. You want to do a bazaar with your waist. That is what you want to do. Which is a sin. No prostitution under my roof. You know, yeah? No prostitution under my roof.
Who is even talking about prostitution? Who is a prostitute?
One day, you will understand me.
I'm talking about Ingrid. Chiadika, send the seat in.
I'm going somewhere.
Send the seat in now! Or do you want to make love to the seat? Oh yeah, go! Sex, 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 all the time. Who could never walk? I'll tell them to come and book turn on you. Hey,
you're good.
Okay. You know, you owe me my 5,000. What's my 5,000?
I owe you nothing.
You owe me nothing?
I owe you nothing.
What do you mean? I left this my handsome he-goat to impregnate your she-goat for 5 weeks, and you're telling me you owe me nothing?
I owe you fuck all. This is not a real he-goat. He couldn't mount any of the she-goats.
So, meaning that this is a trick, not to pay me my money.
Yeah, because it's my goats. I know their condition.
How did you know?
This goat is not a real he-goat. All he did was eat all the palm fodder and shit up the whole compound, making the job very, very hard for the children to sweep up the compound every day.
Okay. Now, look at the whole trunk is finished.
Because I am sure your he goat, your she goat, have been rushing it. Overusing it. Look at how lean the tail has become.
This goat just come on holidays. Enjoy itself.
Don't tell lies against this living because this goat is dumb. Don't tell lies against this goat.
He never mounted any of the she goat.
Okay, you say he couldn't mount. God is looking at. God of this goat is watching you.
He's watching
you. You know that. Okay, fine. So he did not mount any of your goat. If I take it to the backyard now, they will rush it. They will rush my handsome goat. I shall wear weep to the back.
They will be disappointed.
No, don't worry. Don't worry.
He can't do the job.
Don't worry. You said there's no. No, come and show me the place.
Are you saying you put my he-goat in the midst of all these things?
Amadi,
my goat is dead.
Amadi, take the goat back. You don't yet time to bring up the goat for
me. No, what are you saying? You say?
Okay, you are a very dishonest man. Look at that goat there. Is that not pregnancy?
Is that not pregnancy? And you're telling me my goat did not perform?
Bumpo.
Look at it. There are even two. That one is pregnant too. Huh? I don't like this, dealing with dishonest people.
Bumpo. I'm sorry, I did not see those ones before. Now I take your money. 5,000. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, you're not a good person.
Can't you say thank you?
Thank you for what?
Give
you
me all this.
You should be telling me to thank. Do you know how much you are going to make of this thing? Okay. I'm doing all these things just to help all you right, progress I'll, in your goat herding.
I'm coming tomorrow.
For what? Listen, okay, don't even near my house again to say that you want to rent that my goat. Because I will not let you. I don't deal with dishonest people.
Hey, we are friends.
We are not friends.
I'm coming tomorrow.
Please know that I come to this very to see all these pregnant Casanova.
I'm coming tomorrow.
Coming tomorrow to do what?
You can't stop me coming tomorrow.
Don't worry, it is your son. You will come and impregnate your goat.
Anyway, because you were never before. Okay, you were never before. Okay, you were.
all the she-goat are barren. If that is the case, because I know the power of your man, your strength. Don't worry, I'll collect that money for you. And I will ask it for you. Eke said you could not perform. How can you say Eke said such a thing of you? When I can count the number of issue goats you have made pregnant in this community. Eke doesn't want to give us a move. Don't worry, I will revenge you. I know Ubina Baloa. Dipem. I know you. Give us a move. Who is that? Who is that? Who is that?
Wow! This is it! So beautiful!
Here he comes.
Very good.
Our mouthpiece in matters like this.
Yes.
The matter is so far now.
Yes.
Good enough is fine.
What's going on here? Huh?
I'll give you a name.
These local government people.
Come on.
They sent us some fertilizers again. Despite the fact that the ones they sent before has caused a lot of havoc in this village.
A lot.
You see? So we need someone like you. Who can talk to them about this fertilizer issue?
Yes.
Yeah, we don't need this fertilizer. We don't need them.
I thought we had finished with this thing. This matter has been sent to the Igwe before. We even gave a report to the Igwe. Does Igwe know that they are here?
Uncle, Igwe is not a savior in matters like this. He is saving his own skin and being on their side. You know politics. He is afraid that if he opposes the government, they may remove him and put somebody who may listen to them and get into the entire community and get people to also listen to them and pay the heavy fertilizer taxes whenever the suppliers, the small bags of whatever they put inside it, whether shit or rotten vegetables they've mixed together.
This is a goat shit. Our goats can provide enough of this. No need for it to give us all this.
Yeah, you're right.
Excuse me, I have something to say. You must understand that the...
There is nothing you can say. We have said you have confessed, we complained. We went to Awigo and they complained. We don't need this. All this your exploitation, we are tired with it. Do you understand what you are saying? You cannot come here and you are taxing us your 10,000. Do you think it's very cheap? All this your taxation and your exploitation, we say we do not want again. If you cannot come down to the price of this very thing and then subsidize it, if not, we will not.
Yes.
Do you understand what I'm saying? We will not be able to buy it. Fertilize, come to think of it. Did my great-great-grandfather, did our great-great-grandfather, did they use this kind of thing? We have this.
This land.
This is more of poison.
Yes.
I'm telling you. You see that goat there? That is the only one I have now. I used to have them up to 17. Yes. What happened? You people advertised your fertilizer. That first time, you remember that first time he came? We spread it all over. The thing entered, it filtered into even the green grasses that our goats eat. In 1 week, I lost from between 12 to 16 goats. For what? Because they ate the grass treated by your fertilizer. And you're telling me, in spite of that, instead of you
you should be begging us. You should be begging us to take this fertilizer. So instead of begging us, you are not asking us, we don't need it.
Even safe. All my yams had bought the fertilizer. Go and look at them. Very strong.
Very strong. Yes. Even in the barns, if you go to the ones planted with fertilizer, open the decent. They decay very, very fast.
Yes. Look, look, application is the problem. Is tell me, how did you apply it? How did you apply it?
Which kind of application? What application are you talking about? You come here and you exploit people. You are telling us about your local government chairman. Doesn't he come from a village? Let him go to the village and then put it in his own village.
Yes.
Instead of coming here to exploit us. Yes. We don't need your fertilizer. Pure ED. Is it by force?
Look, Mr. Wanko, I can see you are fomenting trouble in this village. Yes. I've had enough of my this. Yes. I will report you to the local government.
Who is the local government man that cannot even reason?
Answer.
In his own village, if he begins to tax people 10,000, how many of the poor farmers do you think will survive?
I don't know.
And you're coming here because you're wearing yellow and black uniform. Yeah. You're trying to do it. In your own village, how many? How many people have you advertised, introduced to this? We don't need your fertilizer. We have our dung sheet, Abi.
Yes, all right.
We have our own local sources of fertilizer. So we don't need this thing.
This must stop this minute. Exactly. What the local government chairman is doing is a noble
thing.
What
is the local government chairman? Are you forcing us in our... You won't get one more.
My friend, sit down.
Get out of this place.
Go. Let him go.
You must stop this immediately.
Go, go.
Stop what?
You should leave here.
I still leave here. No, don't worry. Don't go. Wait for me. Let me come. Don't go.
No, don't go. Wait for me. Let him go.
No, I stay here.
No, where are you going? Wait for me! No, wait! Ununa! This nonsense that you bring here! Look, I imagine he's delightful.
Yeah,
just go. He's good, yeah. We have dealt with this in the
yes.
We say we don't need them.
Is it by force?
No.
Ha!
You don't need it. Get that a lot on now.
Government and win.
Leave me alone. Get your dirty hands off me.
What's happening? Is that the man I sent you inside to arrest?
My father is nowhere to be found. He is not in my house.
My father? Oh, please, Wanko cannot be my father. He's my uncle.
Your uncle? Where is your uncle?
I don't know. Last I heard of him, he was outside brushing his mouth. Anyway, not brushing, washing. My uncle does not brush his mouth. He doesn't use toothbrush. And he believes that anybody that uses toothbrush would have his teeth falling off in the next 10 years. In this day and age, my uncle does not wear trousers. He still goes round this village in a wrapper. If you go in there, you would not even see one trouser. Bet me. Anyway, why are you looking for him? Why do you want to arrest him?
Your uncle is standing in the way of government and fertilizer taxation program.
Oh, really? My uncle doesn't like the government. Reasons best known to him. But maybe you should tell me a little about this fertilizer taxation program.
I would rather tell you what your uncle has done. You see, for the past 5 years, government has noticed that farm produce has reduced tremendously, and farmers are not getting enough for their toil and their hard work in the farms.
Yes.
At this rate, if it continues, there will not be any food for people to eat.
Exactly.
It's so terrible. And this is simply because they do not employ the use of modern farming techniques.
especially the use of fertilizer. And because of this, the local government introduces noble initiative of giving out fertilizers at subsidized prices. For very meager amount of money, you can get as many bags of fertilizer as you want for your farms. But do you know what? Your uncle is standing against this noble initiative. He's doing everything to stop farmers from buying this idea. Can you imagine? He tells them that the fertilizer is not good for the crops and that actually poisonous to the crops. And he goes to tell them that the government is charging so much, and for this reason and many more, we are out to get your uncle.
You know what? Give me 1 second, okay? Just 1 second. 1 second.
My hiding somewhere. I suspect
this.
Yes. What?
All of you should go there. Go ahead. Just go. Go. Good. Yes, both of you. Yes, that's it.
Stop. Stop it this minute.
Wow, hold on. Just one.
Stop it.
Wait. Just
get the camera. Are you dumb?
Wait, just one more.
You don't know that with this picture in the uncle's hand, he will take us to an eating dog and kill all of us.
Get the camera from her this minute. Get the camera.
Susie from her.
Give me my camera.
Look at the picture. Yes, that's the face of the troublemaker.
Wait.
With this, I will give it to the local government chairman and he will deal with it.
No, just give me my camera. My best friend, give me my camera. Bring my camera back.
In this local government to come under the umbrella of this cooperative. What is the better way to preach the message of harmony in this land, the rural community, livestock and animal? All we need to do is to produce this almanac and circulate it all over. And our message of our goodwill is embedded in this picture. Henceforth, every policy we make, be it taxation or rates, or livestock immunization, or child immunization, or even bicycle licensing, or whatsoever. We do not need to go to the village one by one, individual by individual. All we need to do is to get to the cooperative and inform their members. Samantha.
Sir.
You are the best core member we have in this local government. That's why I've come to you this evening.
With all due respect, sir, I'm really flattered. Thank you.
Good. I wish to recommend you for this year's core member award, which comes with a car, a reward of 250,000 naira, and a powerful letter of recommendation from us to you, to any company in this country in which you seek employment after your youth service year. And should you want to stay back with us in this local government, we'll be glad to offer you employment as an official in the local government.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
All these are all we have in stock for you if you win this award. And this is what you must do if you want to win this award. I want you to get this man to give us a permission to use his picture for our Farmers Cooperative Almanac. I understand this man is a local influential man in the village. He is of high repute and he commands respect. If people see him in our almanac, they will know that he is with us and our policies. Please note, I equally understood that he is not a rich man and he is primitive. He is as stubborn as a buffalo. He is uncouth, no finesse. In fact, he is a primitive man.
You have to be careful. Can you do it?
I think I can. I will try, sir. But first, I'll need a little bit of information, details of him, government policies in his community, why the policies were made, the benefits to the rural dwellers, etc., stuff like that.
Well then, no problem. Be in my office first thing tomorrow morning. A private car will be arranged for you, some money for your transport, and a booklet containing my stewardship in this community.
Seriously, sir. How do you expect these people to pay tax? The entire roads to this village are messed up. Gully erosion, bumps. Jeez. Is this not a local government or is it a state road? Whatever it is, sir, these roads are in need of urgent repairs. If I was a pregnant woman driving on this road, I'll be talking about a miscarriage right now. Hello? The line is breaking up, sir. Service is poor, and in the next 10 minutes, as I'm seeing, if I continue driving on this road, I'll lose service on my phone and be completely incommunicado. Hello? Hello? Hello, sir? Hello? Oh, sorry. Hello. I'm looking for one call for Denu village. How far is it from this village and his place? I'm sure she has gone to inform him of the presence of a strange woman who's asking of him, not so. Is that how much people like him here? Please, please, direct me. I mean him no harm. I'm a woman, see? A beautiful one at that. I'm here to marry him. Won't I make him a good wife? Mr. and Mrs. Mwangwo, please, please, direct me to his place. Thank you.
Left. Just enter there.
Okay, enter there. Okay. Bye-bye. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Don't forget to come for my wedding, oh. Okay, my marriage to Wanko.
Bye-bye, ma'am.
Agent from the local government sent to your uncle. My name is Samantha. Friends call me Sam. You must be Chiadika.
Thank you! Thank you!
Okay, so where's your uncle?
The government people want to put him in prison, not so. Because he chased their officials away with a cutlass.
No, not anymore. The government wants to make peace with him. They sent me to make him our friend. They sent me to tell him that. Where can I find him? Can I see him?
No, he's not at home.
Where is he then?
How do I trust you?
I don't know. I just gave you your camera back. What do I look harmful? A certain photograph of his has generated the interest of the local government chairman. We want him to sign and give us permission to use it as the face of the local government farmers cooperative almanac. In exchange, government is ready to give him a bungalow in the city, set him up in any business of his choice.
Really? He better be taking me to the city with him because I actually took that picture.
Really, you did?
Yes, I did.
Wait, are they going to give you a price?
No, why not? I'm sure they can. If you convince him to give us his permission,
using the picture, you know, in our almanac. Of course, I can convince the chairman to give you something. Might be a small prize, though.
Why do you need his signature? You can use it. You don't have to ask him. Listen, my uncle is not that educated. He doesn't even know his right. You can use the picture. I took it and I'm giving you the permission.
Government does not want to do that. They want to do the right thing. They do not want to trample on people's rights. You know there is an opposition party and its candidates. We need your uncle's permission. Okay? If we don't get his permission and the opposition gets to hear about it, they might approach your uncle, tell him about his rights, get him to sue or even sue on his behalf. And that would be wrong. Very embarrassing for the government if they have to settle out of court and all of that. No, we have to do the right thing.
Okay.
Oh, that's it. You, no one is going to bother you henceforth or try to arrest you. I come on behalf of Mr. Ubaka, the local government chairman. I have a good proposal for you, sir.
Is that why you brought her? You spoil my mind.
Yeah, because
you think you're right. The
government. I don't even talk to her. I'm the most important of the city.
Yes, sir.
Do you understand?
Wait, hear her out. You don't know why she came.
Please,
hear her out. Oh, hold on. Please, wait. Oh.
How did you get this?
From my local government chairman, sir. We want your permission to use the picture in our farmers cooperative calendar. We will sell it, raise money to further subsidize the fertilizer for the farmers in the community. That will also help boost agriculture, sir.
Who did this?
Please, it's not her fault. Our officials who came here to arrest you, they seized her camera and they found the picture in it.
I don't know who you are, but I don't care to know. I don't know why you are here. I don't even want to know. But please, what I want you to do now is to leave my house.
No, sir.
Did you say no? I said get out of my house and you say no, sir.
No, please. Listen to her now. Please.
Shut up. You're the cause of all this nonsense in the first instance. If you hadn't brought this rubbish, would we be here?
I drove 3 hours to get here, sir. I want to sit down and talk to you. All I ask is that you listen.
You drove 3 hours.
Yes, sir.
And I'm sure you passed through a road to this very Udenu. Does the road you pass on show any sign of government presence here? Did you see anything that shows you that government is interested in the Udenu community? It's only when they want something, they come. Tell government I'm not interested. The only interest government wants is they come here, they increase their tax. They take tax from almost everybody, even almost the little kids themselves. Bring fertilizer for us to plant. We cultivate with the fertilizer. Where do we carry the proceeds? So if we do not have good proceeds, good roads, and yet they said they need a president. They need me. They need my picture. That's the only time government will run 3 hours through that road to come here. Listen, leave my house. Will you shut up? Listen to her. You're the person who started this nonsense in the first instance. Look at what you want to take of your uncle and want to sell it for public to know, to see how naked I am. Get out of my house. If you don't get out, you will regret it. In fact, if you do not, I'm going to carry you myself and dump you outside.
If you lay a hand on me, you will regret you ever met me, sir.
What did you say?
Don't! Put me down, Mr. Wakwa!
Now, enter this car and leave my compounds. Have you not realized that I am a man of my word? Like I said something, I do it. Now, enter this thing and leave my place.
Uncle, this is not fair. You don't put your hand on a woman like this. It's so wrong. It's not fair. You don't put...
Shut up. You caused this thing in the first instance. It was that your camera. That, where is that camera? I'm going to seize it. For the next 3 weeks, you're not going to touch that camera or see it. Man, what are you still waiting for?
I'm looking for my keys.
Your key? Your key without key? Come on, get out. Carry this thing out of my compound. Government.
Sorry.
And you? What are you still doing? Come on, get out. Enter the house. Pray mantis. And you could continue to bring problem.
Young lady, what do you want from me? What do you really want from me?
To talk. I just want you to listen to me. My name is Samantha, Sam for short. I studied to be a social worker in the university. Currently, I am a youth corps member attached to the Ejinaka Local Government Council. I was sent to ask you to please give us your permission to use that special photo of yours, you and your goat.
This is lemongrass tea for you.
Oh, okay.
I hope you like it. Food will soon be ready. Then you can use this too.
Cover yourself
so you don't feel too cold.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Sir, we just want your goodwill. Since you have so much influence on all other farmers in the community, I mean, your picture on an almanac will mean that you're on the side of government.
I don't want to be on the side of government. I don't want to do business with government. Do you understand? So, I think it is best when you, for you to tomorrow, you go back and tell the government. To me, government is like leper. You have a handshake with them, you get infected. This man sitting here does not want to get infected because government have dealt with me enough. I was in the army, they disgraced me out of the army, he did everything. I took it in good face. Now I came to this very village. What does government want with me again?
This is not about government, sir. It's about the people, the farmers, the rural dwellers.
Rural dwellers. That's what people call us. They refer to us as rural dwellers. Illiterates, bush people that do not know their left from their right. But I think it's government that does not know its left from its right. There's no sort of name they did not call us. I have said I have divorced myself from government. Don't you see how I dress? You see how I do this thing? They tried to frustrate me. I came back to my village. I want to start another life. My own way. I don't care the way I dress, the way I move, what I do. My life is my own. I don't want to be influenced by government. They have influenced me enough. Politicians will come here and say all kinds of nonsense. We don't have water, we don't have hospitals, we don't have all the amenities, even the ones our neighboring communities have, we don't have. And yet, politicians will come here and campaign, bring us bags of rice, share it among the rural dwellers. We will eat and then vote for them. What happens? They go to that very office, they forget you. Not only forgetting you, they make you poorer so that by the next election, you will be hungry enough to canvass for that their rice. And they bring it and you vote for them again. I have said, me, Okonkwo, I'm no longer interested in government. I'm divorced with government and all their dealings. What has government done for me? What has government done for this community? So why are they sending you? What kind of influence do they think that you can get for me to work with government again? Please. We're very hospitable people. If not, I would have asked you the moment you came when we were doing all those things to go. But I did not. Because it's the character of this community to accommodate visitors. I accommodated you. It is not, we are not hostile. Rather, we are hospitable. You understand? That's why I'm sitting here with you now. My niece, you can sleep in her room. You can feel as comfortable as you are, as you want. But tomorrow, we're going to go back to that very good government and tell them, no show. What they ask you to come and get for me and my goat. Why wouldn't government be interested in a photograph with me and a Cadillac, a big car, for instance? They want my photograph with a goat because I am a goat, a semi-goat. It's all right. Tomorrow, go and tell them that. It's no game.
They say you're an illiterate, an original bushman who just charges forward like a buffalo and acts without thinking.
I accept.
How wrong they are. You are not what they say you are. You're very intelligent. Now I know why your people respect you and hold you in such high esteem.
Thank you for your compliments, but I hope this, your compliment is not going to influence our agreement. Tomorrow, you go back to the government and tell the government, I don't want them.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay?
Them
okay.
Go be your close friends.
Chiadika!
When they need your help.
Chiadika!
They use you, them go throw away you. Naim they vex me pass. Imagine people will expel me.
And then get
I want my friendship. I beg you na be leper. Anyone wish I could na go carry. I wanna carry na wahala de go.
So my uncle refused to give his permission. What does he want? Does he want us to rot and die in this village? Wait. Did you tell him what the government is ready to reward him with if he gives his permission to use the picture?
No, I did not. Your uncle is not the kind of man to be swayed by promises of money and life in the city. He's very strong in his beliefs and grudges against government.
So he's not thinking about me? What about me? Hey? Don't I have a future? Or does he think my future is tied to that fan work he does? I will run. It's just that I don't want to hurt him. Because I know he's still mourning his sister, who is my late mother. If not, I would have run since.
Chiadika,
I won't know.
Chiadika, it's a good thing you did not run away. Please stay and continue to beg him. Maybe he will change his mind about the picture. Let me return to the city and tell those who sent me here how my journey went. I will come back if they want me to, okay?
Please buy me chocolates when you're coming back. I've missed chocolates.
I will. Bye bye.
What's wrong?
These people gave me a dead car. Imagine! I think it's a battery. What is it? Yeah. Ah! Oh!
Ah!
Auntie, this guy cannot start you.
Huh?
The problem is not from the battery. Somebody put salt in the engine oil area.
What? Somebody did what?
Honestly. And if you continue starting this car, the engine will knock. You need to get a mechanic to drain the oil completely and flush the engine. Then you put a fresh oil. And I cannot do that now because I don't have the tools and oil. You need to tow the car to the city.
Tow? How do I tow the car?
I don't know, Auntie. Maybe if I get to my shop tomorrow. You know, today is already gone. Look at the time. Then I'll take a bike to the city and get a mechanic.
So how long would that take?
That is tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, everything will be okay.
Do it now. Do it.
Auntie, we need some money for that.
So you're waiting for money? I don't have money. I'll give you. Just go. Go and do it. Just go, go.
Which means 2 extra days. Is that what you're telling me? So you're going to spend a total of 4 days here.
Salt. Salt.
Chadika. Chadika.
Chadika, why?
Why?
Why what?
Don't come from that angle. Don't even try to deny it at all. I know you. I know what you can do. Chadika, what did you put into this woman's car that made the car not to start? I don't want silence. I want you to be answering me. If not, I am going to summon all the three tiers of spirit government. You are going to swear by Amadou Hafez. After that, you swear by the Bible and swear by the Quran. And you know you're finished. You will die. Akwema. So start telling me the truth now. Did you or did you not?
I did it.
You see?
I like this auntie so much. I don't want her to leave just yet. I just put little salt on your engine just to delay you. I didn't mean to spoil your car. I'm sorry.
You are a devil. Chadika, you are a devil. You know that I'm allergic to shit. And then you brought a bag of shit and insist on tying it down to my compound. Ikunsu, I thought you were going to be better than your mother, who was a clear freelance prostitute jumping from one bed to another in the city.
Wanko, stop!
Better stop again. Let her go.
You say such a thing.
Why would I say such a thing? Who knows who is waiting for her in the bush? And by the way, what are you asking me? After all, you are the person who brought this thing into this family.
Me?
Without you, would we have been going through all this, the hassles? You're asking me. Because, please, I don't know whether Samaritan or Samantha, whatever your name is, whatever bond you think that is holding us together, correct? Leave this compound before I vent my spleen on you. Pack and go and leave my family alone. Biko.
Okay, well, it puts on Wara. Udo, can I yo? Call biggie that you are. Nabata, come na yo? Call biggie that you are. It was in you,
you were,
Chadika! Chadika! Chadika!
me.
What are you doing here?
I want to try and see if I can find Chiadika.
As what? As a mother or as an interested party? As an auntie? From overseas, who have come to love my niece more than the uncle.
Look at you. I have said leave this place. Don't touch you. I will succumb to your pressure. Leave myself and my family alone. How will you put yourself on a family that does not want you?
Why can't you be nice? Why are you such a hard-hearted and harsh man? What kind of uncle tells his niece that her mother was a prostitute? You have just proven beyond a doubt that you are very harsh and hard-hearted. Wherever that girl is now, she's heartbroken, she's in pain, she's in sorrow. Why don't you just try and be nice? It might be difficult, but it doesn't cost you anything. We better go and find her before she does any harm to herself.
Thank you, advisor. You are advising me on how to control my family. Do you understand? I have told you to pack and go. If you were not here in the first place, would I talk harshly to my niece? If you are not in here, whose vehicle will she send you to the engine? It's a problem. Leave this village. Go pack your niece and take your bag.
Look at you. You think I want to stay here?
Yes, you want to
you
stay
think
here.
I want to? I'm happy wearing this one outfit. Since 2 days, you think I'm happy wearing this one out? Yeah, I like it. I am tired. I want to leave. I'm sick and tired of this village. Tired of being blamed and dragged into your domestic problems. And most of us sick of wearing this one blouse and this one jean.
And what pant?
What?
You said one jeans and one top, so I completed it for you. And what pant?
So you even like women? And you say you're a revolutionary. Revolutionary my ass.
I'm not interested in your big grammar. I've asked you to go. I'm not interested in knowing the meaning of your big grammar.
If you spent more time in school, instead of fighting development, you would have known what the word revolutionary means. You think I planned it to stay here? I would have brought a whole box of clothes if that was my plan. I brought one nightgown to spend one night here. I'm tired. Sick and tired. I'm all sweaty and gummy inside.
You should have told me that you are gummy inside. In fact, if you have got the complaint to me, I would have shown you to the street. You go there and then take your bath. Clean up. I can lend you my wrapper. So you use it. You can even tie it and wash these ones until they are dry. Instead of coming here to tell me you're coming inside here. It's not my fault, but
excuse me, Mr. Wanko. My privates are not your business.
Oh, my own privates. It's not, it's your own business. It's the business of government. Yeah? My recruit is your business. The whole rank and file of my family is your business and that of the government. But yours is not mine. They want me to come and stay naked. And then take my picture and show the whole world. Because you people are doing a calendar. Go and tell them that I will not succumb to that pressure. You, here. If I ask you to remove your dress now, not even to take any photograph, okay, will you do it? Just ask the two of us. Will you do it?
What are you looking at?
What are
you looking at?
I'm looking at
what are you?
Why? Is this a girl to look at your dress? What's your dress made of? Is it made
go
of
food? That way and look for your niece. I'll go this way.
As what? Go and waste your time. You are looking for crying more than the bereaved. And
Etufulo lilanya, mbodi kolilanya di. You don't have to lose hope, even when there is no hope. Ikambulagi no bigi, makani magi echigabu. Never you give up. Even when there is hold up, come what may, there is hope. As long as there is life,
there is hope.
Whether in the village,
there is hope.
Even in the city, wherever you are,
there is hope.
Whatever you do,
there is hope.
She, stop crying, please. Don't mind your uncle, he just has a very bad mouth. Did not mean what he said.
Hmm? How can you call my mother a prostitute? Okay. Auntie Samantha, look at me. Do I look like the daughter of a prostitute?
No, you don't. You don't. Please, dry your eyes, eh? Come on. You know what? Come, we'll go and look for your uncle. I will make sure he apologizes to you and takes back his words. Okay? Come. Dry your eyes. Come, let's go.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Have you seen Wanko?
Wanko. Yes.
Where?
He said.
Etu fulo lilanya, mwadi kolilanya di. You don't have to lose hope, even when there is no hope. Ikambula gi no bigi, makani magi echigabu. Never you give up, even when there is hold up. Come what may, there is hope. As long as there is life, there is hope. Whether in the village, there is hope. There even is in hope. The city, wherever you are, there is hope. Whatever you do, there is hope. Never you give up.
Wanko, I told your niece that you lied about her mother being a prostitute before she died and that you only said it out of anger. So I want you to tell her that you lied. Tell the poor girl that you lied and apologize to her. Are you going to do the right thing or not? Or you're just going to remain in your foolish local pride? I refuse to apologize because you think that apologizing means accepting defeat or it makes you seem less than the local champion that you are. No, surprise me.
Adanne, come and sit on my legs. Yeah,
oh, God. No, he's calling you. Your uncle is calling you.
Come, madam, get us pepper soup. 3 plates of pepper soup. Sit down.
Thank you.
I lied about you. I didn't know it. It was out of anger. That's why I said that. What? Sorry.
Oh,
sorry.
Why is it that you always mention prostitutes at the slightest provocation? The other day he said that it is not a sin to go to the city, but prostitution is a sin. When I asked you who is a prostitute, you said you would tell me one day. And today you told me that my mother is a prostitute. Is there something you're not telling me?
No. I said I'm sorry. It's out of anger. I apologize. You know, I am short-tempered. And when that temper comes, I just open my mouth and then let the steam out. It's not that I meant exactly what I said. What? I will never ever remember.
Chica, come and sit down. Me.
When God decides to remember you, he can pass through anything. Your stubbornness could bring you to where you think you will never reach. God might even get you a friend who could lead you to your destiny. Do not judge the present with the past, because it's God that holds your future.
Oh. There is hope
anywhere you are.
There is hope
wherever you
are. There is hope. There is hope.
You can't sleep.
Yeah.
I saw you sneak out of the sitting room. You thought I was asleep, but I wasn't. You look sad and troubled. Would you like to talk to me about it?
There is nothing to talk. I'm okay. There's no this. I didn't sneak out anyway. I just decided to come outside. There's nothing to tell.
You can talk to me.
What do you want to hear? Story of my life? There's nothing interesting about story of my life.
I'm listening.
Fine. I was a soldier. I got recruited when they came here looking for people who are going to enter them. I think I was the only person in this village who went for the selection. I was selected, though with my Passing 6 then, Passing 6 certificate, first school leaving certificate. I went to the army. I stayed there for four years. I was dismissed from the army. I came back home. There's nothing much about my life. It's not
Interesting. Okay, you were talking about, you mentioned you were in the army. Tell me about army, privates and recruits. I thought you were joking.
Oh, you thought I was joking? No, I was not joking. No. I was a military man. Well, what really happened was that I went to the city and got married. But when they sacked me and I had to come back home with my wife, and then started farming ever since then.
Wait, wife? Did you say wife?
Oh, yes. I was married. So when they sacked me, I came back home. So I decided to do farm work. But unfortunately, my wife ran away with one man who came to do on a rural water project in my place. My wife ran away. Probably she saw something better in me. And that was since that time I died inside. That woman killed me inside. Later, I even went to the police. Do you know what the man had to do? That was even the bad part. He went to the city and he was telling them that my people were pursuing him and all that and all that and all that. I went to the city to defend myself. They did not even believe me. In fact, I died since that time and now.
Wow. No wonder you have many reasons to hate the government and the city. I mean, your military experience and the engineer you took your wife to the city.
You see, the worst part, my wife unfortunately died in the man's hand. And he had to remarry. The new wife started maltreating Chiadika, and I had to go back to the village and bring her back, I mean to the city.
Why? She's not your daughter. Couldn't her engineer of a father protect her from his new wife?
It's like you're not following me.
I don't understand.
I married. I came back after they sacked me from the army. Came back with my wife here. My wife saw a man and followed the man to the city, taking our four-year-old daughter to the city. And that daughter happens to be Chiadika.
What?
Yeah, she's my biological daughter.
No, you have to tell her so that she feels that she belongs here and that she's not a total stranger. You have to tell her.
Tell her. So what am I going to give her as a reason why the mother had to go and run away with another man?
Wait, is that why you called her mother a prostitute?
Was she not? And I didn't want her to that lie.
Well, there has to be a way for you to tell her without revealing what her mother did. Oh, no wonder the bitterness and everything. Oh, I'm really sorry.
So that should tell you that next time when you want to pass judgment, you don't pass from a distance. Get closer to the person before you judge.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Why are you looking at my breasts?
Me looking at your breasts?
I saw you looking at my breasts.
How can you accuse me? Let's not accuse on me. Looking at your breath for what? Why would I be looking at your breath? To my this is not even real. Like your hair is not real.
It's my hair.
Your fingernails is not real.
They are real.
That I know you guys from the city. You said I'm looking at your breath. But I know that you people even go and buy this what you call Wonder Brazier or Wonder Bra. Take it to prop the thing on. Is that what I should waste my time on?
Mr. Iwankwa, please do not disrespect me. Please, I am not your wife who left you. Don't pour your anger on me.
You cannot even be. My wife was original, even though she was not original in certain areas. But rather than look at you, why would I? Do you know you have insulted me? And you're turning to say I insulted you, to say I was looking at your breast. At this my age, I have some natural breasts to look at. They can even show me for free. Even your buttocks, who knows now, it might even be artificial. Let me tell you, you cannot come and accuse me of looking at your breast and expect me to just leave it like that. But if rather than go for your kind of reason, I will go to the village and find the original one. Instead of people.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wanko. Thank you so much for the insult.
Yeah, you are insulting me too.
Thank you. Thank you. You hear? Thank you very much. Now I know why you deserve everything that you got. Your story is sad, but you deserve everything. The engineer needs to steal your wife a million times over.
Thank you.
Tomorrow I'll leave your house. Thank you.
Leave. I didn't ask you to come in the first instance. Looking at your breast. Didn't you make him?
You were. blessing in where we go. Okay, when it may be fair. Okay, when it will turn.
Madam, I've finished.
Ah, will it start?
Yes.
You are
I,
sure?
Yeah, yeah, I started it and you can try.
Thank you.
So you have the authority to bring a man into my house?
Sibe, no.
Leave me alone, Mac Tam, come. And you are not even afraid to come to
my house.
Leave him! Uncle, come.
Oh, you are alone!
Look! Move away, move! Move away, move! Is that what you are about to do? Under my roof! You have to take your car to the garage, not bring in the garage.
Uncle, I will do as I like. I will do as I like because my life does not begin and end in this village. I will do as I like. Or you sign that picture and then we'll go to the city and leave.
Who's going to sign the picture?
You!
So you can go to the city and leave. I can see every part of you is vibrating for the city. I know what you are looking for in the city. It's not job, it's not prospect. All the things, look at your chest is shaking. Your backside is shaking. Because at this very age, they can move. Let me tell you, people are going to panel beat you until you die. You don't know me.
Uncle, let me tell you something. Let me tell you, this boy is not a village boy. He's not a village boy. He just came to stay with his grandmother for holiday.
Okay.
He saw me, he said he will take me to the city. I will run away with him. Oh, you think you can spoil my life? You cannot spoil my life. If you don't allow me to run away with him, I will stay here, I will get pregnant for anybody I see, and I will bring you shame.
Okay, yes. So this is foreign material. You imported it. Eh? I'm not surprised.
Uncle, sign the picture.
You can eventually go and look. Your mother was carrying her own on a saucer, like cola nut, assuring to everybody who cares, who has a penny, and get water and water. So I'm not surprised. That's why your worth is
Auntie, tell him to come and sign this picture.
You don't know whose house you are going to. Let me know. Your father should be renting.
Leave him alone.
I'll kill you. Your father should be renting you like I rent my he-dog. He-goat. Do you understand me? Your father should make money from you. Rent you to all these barren women so that you can impregnate them. You, come to my house. You don't have to keep on. I'll kill you. Open, leave me. Your father should be right. Rent you out to barren women.
Thank you.
I was about to send a search party to look for you in Udenu village.
You sent me to a goat, sir.
I would have been surprised if you thought of him anything better than a goat. That is governance for you. You meet all manner of people, good and bad.
Did he sign?
No, he did not sign, sir.
Sit down.
You mean he did not sign after you had told him all the goodies you have in store for him if he signs?
I did not tell him, sir.
Why?
Sir, he's not the kind of man to be swayed by such offers.
Did you try?
He wouldn't even give me a chance. He found every opportunity to badmouth me and the government. The man has his own personal problems. His daughter running wild on him, past love issues, career disappointments, all of that.
Then get prepared to go back there.
Jeez, no, you can't be serious, sir. I really dislike the man. I can't stand him. He's insufferable. He's annoying.
Is that the kind of report you want to be in your file in this local government that you felt?
No, sir.
Then get prepared to go back. Can take some more clothes, spend more days, we'll get some more money available for you for inconveniences, in as much as you get results.
Yes, sir.
Sam.
Sir.
That man in the village is just a man. You are a woman. Use it.
Your hand is paying you what? It will not pay you. What do you want? Okay. I hear that there is a Hugot here who has come to holidays.
I want you to produce that Hugot because it's causing catastrophe in this community.
Call him!
This boy will put me in trouble. Within this little time he comes for holidays.
King! Eze! Eze! Come here!
That is the bingo. Okachi, be careful. He's cutting eye for the girl. I'm going to report him. Look at him. He's blowing whistle with his mouth.
King, did you go to his house? Eh?
Nama, with Yerinti. Asa!
He frequents my house!
I'm asking you, did you go to his house?
You don't want to answer. He comes to my house. I want not to learn that solemn. I can tolerate anything in this community, but for him to be coming close to this girl is dangerous both ways because I can finish him. You understand? I have just come here so that tomorrow when you hear that I did this, one God did this or did that, you will know I'm justified to do it. That was why I. Kateba, let me see how you people will be cutting eye. This boy comes to my place. I am not surprised that he's doing this. Because you know your first daughter. The mother is the same thing. The mother, your daughter, I'm not ashamed to say it, was carrying her own like a saucer. Sharing it to everybody in the community. Do you understand? But this boy is solemn. If not, you have to take care of this boy or they'll turn your place into a maternity. The way I see him, he's on fire. Give everybody a Eze. He now answers King. King with Yerinti. Come on, guys, a queen. Warn him for me. Oh, but this is your manhood. If ever, this is your phallus. Come to my house. Anything that happens to your manhood is your fault. Do you understand? How about you go me awusi and ilobun? Come on, go. When you came here,
did you go to his house? I'm asking you, did you go to his house?
Mama, what does that guy think he is? What does he think he is in this village? Some sort of local terrorist?
Please, I'm asking you, did you go to his house?
No, I mean, this guy is crazy. He's mad! But did I tell you he fought me when I went to his house? He fought me! I respected his age. I swear, I would have given him a beating of his existence.
Don't go to his house. Don't go to his house. Ada Tanteata. Oda Anuife. Even the government people are begging him to be their friend. He refused. The story is all over the village now. The government has even sent him a wife to beg him to be their friend, and he refused. Please, is this such a man you want to challenge? Eh? No, instead you cut your holidays with me and go back to the city.
Mama, Mama, can't you see that that girl is gorgeous? Can't you see she's pretty? Who would you go to his house again and again the way I intend to be doing? Hey, Mama. Mama, let me tell you. If that man doesn't want me to go to his house to see this girl, myself and that beauty will choose another place we'll meet.
You will not.
I will. Mama, that is how to find a wife. Yes. Mama, I'm not of age to get a wife. Am I not? Next year, I'll be out of university. I will get a job. What is the next thing? I'll get married. What else? Oh, he thinks that nobody will stand him in this village. He thinks nobody can stand him in this village. Okay, I will stand him. Tell my uncle I said, I will stand him in this village, no matter what it is. After all, this is my maternal home, and nobody can harm me in this place.
Please, my son. Please.
Let him wait for me. I'm coming to his house.
Hey. My son, I'm an old woman, no.
Okay.
I was about to send a search party to look for you in Udenu village.
You sent me to a good son.
I would have been surprised if you thought of him anything better than a goat. That is governance for you. You meet all manner of people, good and bad.
Did he sign? No, he did not sign, sir.
Sit down. You mean he did not sign after you had told him all the goodies you have in store for him if he signs?
I did not tell him, sir.
Why?
Sir, he's not the kind of man to be swayed by such offers.
Did you try?
He wouldn't even give me a chance. He found every opportunity to badmouth me and the government. The man has his own personal problems, his daughter running wild on him, past love issues, career disappointments, all of that.
Then get prepared to go back there.
Jeez, you can't be serious, sir. I really dislike the man. I can't stand him. He's insufferable. He's annoying.
Is that the kind of report you want to be in your file in this local government that you felt?
No, sir.
Then get prepared to go back. Can take some more clothes. Spend more days. We'll get some more money available for you for inconveniences.
in as much as you get results.
Yes, sir.
Sam.
Sir.
That man in the village is just a man. You are a woman. Use it.
You are depending on what? They will not pay you. What do you want?
Okay. I hear that there is a he-goat here who has come to holidays.
I want you to produce that he-goat because it's causing catastrophe in this community. Call him!
This boy will put me in trouble within this little time he comes for holiday.
King! Eze! Eze! Come here!
That is the bingo. Okachi, be careful. He is cutting eye for the girl. I've got to report him. Look at him. He's blowing whistle with his mouth.
King, did you go to his house? Eh?
Nama, with Yelinti. Asa!
He frequents my house!
I'm asking you, did you go to his house?
You don't want to answer. He comes to my house. I want not the lady as him. I can tolerate anything in this community, but for him to be coming close to this girl is dangerous both ways because I can finish him. You understand? I've just come here so that tomorrow when you hear that I did this, one God did this or did that, you will know I'm justified to do it. That was why I. Kateba, let me see how you people will be cutting eye. This boy comes to my place. I am not surprised that he's doing this. Because you know your first daughter. The mother is the same thing. The mother, your daughter, I'm not ashamed to say it, was carrying her own like a saucer. Sharing it to everybody in the community. Do you understand? But this boy is solemn. If not, you have to take care of this boy or they'll turn your place into a maternity. The way I see him, he's on fire. Give him a Eze, he now answers King. King with Yelinti, come on, as a queen. Warn him for me. Obatabem, this is your manhood. If ever, this is your phallus. Come to my house. Anything that happens to your manhood is your fault. Do you understand? How about you go me a wussy and you lobo? Come on, go! When I came here,
when I come, give me a say, you put it. When I have.
Did you go to his house? I'm asking you, did you go to his house?
Mama, what does that guy think he is? What does he think he is in this village? Some sort of local terrorist?
Please, I'm asking you, did you go to his house?
No, I mean, this guy is crazy. He's mad. But did I tell you he fought me when I went to his house? He fought me. I respected his age. I swear, I would have given him a bit of his existence.
Don't go to his house. Don't go to his house. Ada pante ada. Oda anuife. Eh? Even the government people are begging him to be their friend. He refused. The story is all over the village now. The government has even sent him a wife to beg him to be their friend, and he refused. Please, Is this such a man you want to challenge? Eh? No, instead you cut your holidays with me and go back to the city.
Mama, Mama, can't you see that that girl is gorgeous? Can't you see she's pretty? Who would go to his house again and again the way I intend to be doing? Hey, Mama, Mama, let me tell you, if that man doesn't want me to go to his house to see this girl, eh? Myself and that beauty will choose another place we'll meet.
You will not.
I will. Uh-uh. Mama, that is how to find a wife. Yes. Mama, I'm not of age to get a wife. Am I not? Next year, I'll be out of university. I will get a job. What is the next thing? I'll get married. What else? Oh, he thinks that nobody will stand him in this village. He thinks nobody can stand him in this village. Okay. I will stand him. Tell my uncle I said, I will stand him in this village, no matter what it is. After all, this is my maternal home, and nobody can harm me in this place.
Please, my son.
Let him wait for me, oh. I'm coming to his house.
Son, I'm an old woman, no.
Hello, welcome. I'm back. There was no one in the house, so I thought I might as well tidy up the place. How was your outing? It's good to see both of you go out together for an outing again.
Okay. All right.
Oh, you came back. Still, I thought you abandoned me.
Oh, Archie, how are you?
I'm fine. Just my uncle's usual trouble. Mm-hmm. Hey, you saw that day now that he embarrassed my new boyfriend. Can't you remember the day you left?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, today again, he took me to their house and warned their grandmother to tell him to stay away from me.
Really?
Yes.
Anyway, there's enough time for that. Huh? We'll talk. Come, mm-hmm. See what I got for you.
Hey, you left your bag outside.
There was no one in the house when I came. Have you forgotten?
Okay, I'll just help you.
Hold on. Mm-hmm. I hope you like it.
Ah, chocolate!
You didn't even open it to see what's in.
I know, Papa Chocolate. Thank you.
Open it. Open it.
You have opened this, Papa.
Like it?
Are you still
Bag, inside. Open the door.
Look, there's an unwanted visitor in my house. And I want her to leave this village for good.
Is it the government wife we heard about? I thought they said he did not want her. So she has not gone still.
Government wife? Which government wife are you talking about?
We heard that the government went and paid her bride price and gave her to you to marry so that you can be their friend.
Uh-huh.
That's what we heard though.
Ah! Village rumor. There is nothing that they cannot see in the village. And the thing is that their rumor spreads like wildfire. little bit of fallacy, a little bit of false, a little bit of lies, and all those things.
Wait, wait, are you saying that the government did not send any wife to you?
Abel, I am not here to discuss what the government, whether the government sent me a wife or a concubine. I am saying that I have a thorn in my flesh, that somebody I want to be scared out. In fact, I want people to, you people to scare her in such a way that she will not ever think of coming back to this day at all.
I'm sorry. But sir, just what exactly do you want me to do?
Now, tomorrow I am going to send Chiadika out. In fact, almost the whole day is this thing. I'll make sure she's not around. Me, I will be around, but I will be hiding. Carry about three boys, organize about three or four boys, you know. Maybe you mask yourself. Come to my house. It's only her that you get. Scare her, scare the living daylight out of her. That you want to begin to move out immediately.
Oh, Tiara Nudelu!
Nyamon.
Consider it done. In fact, as I'm talking to you now, I'm even seeing her now running away from the village.
Running away?
Isn't that one what you want to?
If she runs, this lady came with a vehicle. She came with a car, and the car is in my back in my house. If she runs, I don't want you people to make her to start from there, begin to run away. Because if you run, she's going to come back for that hacker. I want you to scare her to the extent that she would say, okay, fine, now I'm leaving for good. She'll go into her car, pack up her swag, and then leave this village. You know the kind of scare you're going to give her now. Scare her enough.
Man, you can go.
Can you do it?
Consider it done.
Fine. So whichever way it will do to come, I will aid you along the line. Yeah? Now, let me drop.
No, don't worry. After the job, I'll come for you.
Chiadika, you're not going to take the... You are taking the food away. Take the washing...
I'm coming now. Let me finish this chocolate. I'll move it. I've been the one moving the...
That thing you're taking will spoil your teeth. I'm telling you.
This small thing I'm taking. Do you know the last time I took chocolate? Since I came back from the city, I've not seen chocolate too. Talk more of eating it. Only this small one will come and spoil
my... I will advise you to concentrate on eating our local food. They contain of it. Forget this chocolate. Except you want to spend your old age in hospital. Go and ask others what they are talking about.
I bought these for you from the city.
Oh.
You brought it for me from the city?
Yes.
So why are you just giving it to me now? Since you came back.
I was waiting for you to finish your dinner. I wanted you to use them and, you know, wash down your dinner. I wish there was electricity. I would have preferred you had it, you know, chilled.
You would have preferred. So what you are insinuating is I should be doing what you prefer. You are not ordering me in my house, so gradually this is how it starts.
Please, Mr. Manko, every little thing I say to you does not have to make you upset. Huh?
Thank you very much. I'm not interested. I prefer my palm wine to this.
Uncle, this is a gift now. You don't reject gifts. Can you reject it?
All right, let me have it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I also brought you multivitamins, if you don't mind.
That's so thoughtful of you. He needs it.
The rumor now making rounds in the village is that you are my wife. The government married a woman and sent the woman to me. And that is the rumor.
What?
What do you mean? What's that expression for? As if you are you too big to be my wife? No. Are you saying you cannot be my wife? I'm too little for you. Is that what you're...
Can you remember the things you said to me? You said my hair was fake, my nails were fake, my breasts were fake. I put Dunlop in my buttocks, thereby making them fake. Can you remember all those things you said to me?
Yeah, I remember all those things, but those things are past. If they tell you now to be my wife, won't you agree? Don't you have, you know, have you not been cutting eye even in my back for me?
Can you, after saying all those things to me, ask me to be your wife? I imagine that I want to be that. Other than do the job I was sent to do here, get you to sign the documents, giving us permission to use your photograph in our almanac.
And you say you know I'm not
good night
to you at all. Tomorrow, I'm going to send you to Akukala's place. It is very far, but you have to go there. My egos have spent more than 1 week there. So when you get there, get me 2,000 naira from the man.
2,000 naira?
Yes. Look, you have sent this in. I'll send this one. The WhatsApp message, send it to you.
I'll send it. Uncle. This is my uncle there. Like it, you know? One call. Hello? Who's there? Oh my God, who are you? Who are you? Please.
Stop up.
Please don't hurt me, please.
Hurt you? Did I hear you say hurt you? We cannot hurt you. But the chief priest of our shrine is going to hurt you.
That's right.
So you are going to use it for sacrifice.
No, yes. Please, what?
You know, strangers are good for sacrifice.
Oh, please, wait for Mr. Wanko to come back. I am his visitor, please, just wait. Wait, you can't use this guest for a sacrifice.
No, I am for sacrifice.
Please, no, I'm Wanko's wife to be. I'm his wife to be. Where is I'm his wife to be? Please, please, you can't do this. Why don't you wait and you ask him? Okay. Why don't you ask Wanko, please? Why don't you wait for Wanko to come? Wait for him to come.
What kind of nonsense is this? What is this? You kind of carrying a woman?
You are asking me to remove my hand. Huh? We are spirit people.
My will like it and normal. You are spirit people. Look at the way you are trying to lift her. You are just lifting. Did anybody ask you to go and lift her and press up? Fuck lift.
But now you are the one that sent us to come and scare her away. Huh? Why are you now doing this thing to us? Is it good?
Scare her away. Did I ask you to come and scare her breast away? Look at the way you are putting your miserable hands under her and lifting. Is that how to lift? Huh? Now remove all this nonsense on your face. You think I'm joking? Remove this thing and I'll run back to your home. Now, I thought you people are sensible enough. Run home! You on the ground, I lifted you for you to even sit, not to stand. I will bury you, that's the next thing. When will you leave these things or change?
Look at this, baby. Go away! Humble. Orchin.
Ebe, is it me that you're looking at that? Ebe. My dear wife, I heard you when you were telling them. Oh, no, don't kill me. I'm his wife. You see, you never told me what was on your
mind. Unbelievable!
I never knew you loved me like that. See, don't worry. You know, if you had told me, come, an open invitation. You want me to come? You see it. I'm coming. Honey! So you came here to sit down.
So you sent people to molest me. Why? I want to stay.
You want to stay as what? To do what?
I want to help out in the farm. I'm really, really trying to like you. Even though you hate me.
Is that the new techniques? That's what they taught you. Use soft words on him, you know, and soften him. You know, women's semantics. It doesn't work with this man. Go and tell them to teach you another style. It doesn't work.
I don't know what you're talking about. No one taught me or told me anything. I'm speaking from my own mind.
Your mind is hollow. Your word is hollow. To me, there's no soul in it. Even if there is soul, I'm not interested.
Tell them to change techniques. This man is not interested.
I know you're still hurting from what your ex-wife, Chiadika's mother, did to you. And it's natural to carry forward that aggression to every woman you come across. But sometimes it still pays to accept new friends. Give them a chance.
Santana or Sama, whatever your name is. Is it because of the smile I gave to you back there? I was mocking you. That is called mockery. I'm not softening. Go and learn another style. This style is not working. You're not acne fan. I want you out of my company.
When God decides to remember you, he can pass through anything. Your stubbornness could bring you to where you think you will never reach. God might even get you a friend who could lead you to your destiny. Do not judge the present with a...
I caught you.
Why are you quarreling with that shop? Why are you quarreling with those things?
What's wrong? Am I not doing a good job?
Have you gone to the farm before? I'm sure you haven't.
You're not working well. Am I not?
I'm working. Look.
Waiting. Let me show you how to do it. See where you're hitting it.
Yeah.
You don't because you waste all your energy. Go down here.
There.
Cut all these ones. You don't even need to hold anything.
Okay.
Then it can remove all this, instead of cutting one and one after the other. And make sure that you get the whole thing.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Okay.
Use your energy and do it.
I'm praying. I want to go to the toilet.
Are you taking permission to leave? You know, everywhere is toilet here.
Yes, I want to go inside the bush.
Go inside the bush or outside the bush. This is God giving latrine for everybody.
So inside the bush, outside the bush. All of them are the same.
I won't be long. I'm coming. Samantha,
see
you.
Let me
okay. Go.
Bye, Daddy.
God, beware of snakes, so.
I will.
Come on, follow me.
Hey.
Can't you raise your knife? What are you doing? No, listen. When you want to cut, that's not the way to do it. This is the way you go to hold your knife. What is this? Blisters? You don't come out now?
It's okay, it's nothing. I'll have to get used to it. I'll have to get strong in a local kind of way, especially now.
That we are with local people, bush people. No, complete it.
I didn't mean it like that. Mm-hmm. I didn't.
How do you
anyway, mean? I'm glad you said that we are friends. It's nice. It's really nice.
No. Friends as in friends. It's not that kind of, not friend like friend. What am I talking about? Let's walk.
Can I hold you?
Hold me.
Yeah.
Before we finish, we walk. What kind of hold you?
You're smelling, man. Man.
What is this? Farm love. Jello, Bolo. Can I walk? If I don't walk again because of these blisters, come.
What should I do?
Just sit, stand there and watch me. You know that. You see the blister that I'm telling you about?
That's
you want to cut? Why?
I don't know. See, I ate cassava this morning. See, I ate apple this morning. Do you know what they call that in this village? It's cassava. It's not in my mouth.
I know. But Mama. What's the essence of saying I love you when I can't kiss you like that? Yes. You have to kiss me.
No, God. See, even if I kiss you with the smell in my mouth, it will not be.
Don't you know that the sweetness of the kiss is the sweetness of the past that commands the use to keep it? Don't you? Yes.
Yes.
You like it?
Yes.
I'll say it. I mean, the sweetness of the kiss is the sweetness of the heart.
Complete it. The sweetness is death. That is what you are looking for.
Good afternoon.
So, this is the toilet that you told me you were going to. I'm impressed. You're able to pass out a whole man. What a lump of shit.
I just saw him now.
You just saw him. He was doing Kumasi, American Wonder. He jumped, ninja.
Papa!
No, leave me, let me. Have you? Wait. You dare to come to my house?
Stop! What is going on here? Stop it!
Stop it! You want to look?
Please,
please,
no. Let me handle it. Please, just go. You see her? That is wrong. You don't know a lady like that. You come to the house. You don't just do it hide. Come to the house and show her respectably. Yes, her uncle will fight, but you'll be tired. And then he'll let you sit out, talk to her in the open. What's your name?
My name is King.
King, you want to kill the future in law before you even have a chance to marry his niece? Give me the cutlass. If you want to see Chandika, I am officially her aunt, so do as her auntie says, okay? Go.
I'm sorry, auntie.
Good, go. Go.
Thank you, auntie.
When a little girl who does not know anything about farm work goes into farm work, what does she get? Blister.
We used to own a farm when I was little. In my village, I ran away.
You ran away?
Yes, because I didn't want to end up a farmer. I wanted more for myself. So I ran to my auntie in the big city. She took me through primary school, trained me up to university stage. My father and my brothers, they stayed back in the village. Ow! My brothers are married now with kids. I guess they two are happy in their own way.
Yay, that means I'm not alone.
No, you're alone in your own pursuit. In her own, she ran away from the village into university. You are trying to run away into king so that the king can mess you up. After messing you up, you will continue with your circle of running. I'm telling you, listen, why don't you cool your head? Read your book in this village. Pass your entrance into university and see whether I will not help you to run away into university.
Chadika, that is a challenge you should say you have taken up.
Okay, I've taken it up.
Uh-huh. Good.
It's not as if I don't. I love education too much. I didn't have the opportunity myself. Sorry, my dear. Mm. You see, if I had been educated up to, let me just say, even up to secondary school level, I would have ended up a senior officer in Nigerian Army. And now you should be issuing people orders instead of receiving these orders from people. How would I be more comfortable? So who doesn't like education? Anybody around me who wants to go to school will always be encouraged. So I'm asking you, I will encourage you, I will even, my last kobo, I will spend it if you really want to school.
Sorry. How?
Sorry.
Next time, if you want to go to that very farm, I'll give you foam, this Dunlop material, remember? So that you can, wrap it around the head of the machete before you run with it. Sorry. Hey, you're so delicate.
I'm not delicate.
You are.
I'm not delicate.
Thank you.
What is this? Disco or jogging? If you want to jog, go to the road.
Good morning, Mr. Wankwo. Morning.
Good morning. This is not the place for jogging.
Would you like to join me and keep fit?
Join you?
Yes.
In jogging?
Yes.
A retired soldier? Don't challenge a retired soldier.
Jogging? Let's go. I'm ready.
You want me to come and jog with you?
Yes.
Okay. Let me get my shoes.
I'm here waiting. Oh, this I've got to see. Nothing.
Because of my dress? No, look, I was one of the best dressed men in those days. And yet my wife left me. So who am I dressing for? No. Let us go. Are you ready?
We go.
One, two, 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 one, two. Jogging is good, you know. It makes you keep fit.
Yes.
I remember my army days. There was one funny adjutant we used to have that time. He would come and join us in jogging. Ah, that man. After 5 minutes. Yeah. He would join up in jogging. After quaffing a whole load of beer, this man will join us. I will continue to jog. After 20 minutes, this man will be panting like a horse. I will talk, huh? Why would this? He said, no, he wants to catch his breast. Very funny man. At a stage, he will just sit down.
Like this?
Yeah, just as I'm doing.
Okay.
And then he will be panting. He will be panting. Hmm. I said, why would this man come and join us? Then he will quaff beer again. The next day, he will come and join us again. After about like
1 second, he will start panting like a horse.
1 second.
I'm just trying to help you out. You know, the time keeps diminishing. First, you said 20 minutes, 5 minutes, then 1 second.
I'm trying to tell you what's happened to my commandant. You know, like it's me that is greeting. This man is a senior officer who is supposed to live by example, but he's panting. He's panting.
You are not panting like that.
No. I said this man will come. It's not time we want to where to lean. It's okay. We saw a get up, he said no.
Mr. Wankwo!
Yes, sir!
Are you starting to breathe like a horse? You start breathing like a horse.
Telling lies?
No, not at all.
If you dare challenge me, you will die.
We go.
Is it a challenge? Okay, fine. Let's start by warming up.
We have already warmed up.
No, second phase. Okay. We have first phase. We have second phase.
Okay.
Ah, that man, he will delay us. First of all, he will say, one, two.
Mr. Wankwo, start let's go.
Gradually.
There was light. I would have laid under the fan till it was time to shower.
That is one of the things we have to tell them in that very city. That we pay our electric bills here. And yet, nobody gives us light.
I will tell them. I'll tell them.
Chadikan! Chadikan!
Probably this girl has gone out again.
See? I've not seen her today. I've not seen her this morning.
What kind of a problem is this girl going to be?
It's her age. She will outgrow the stage. I hope she has bought the university entrance examination forms.
No, she has not. But I've given a message to the village postmaster. As soon as the form comes out, he's going to bring me one. If this girl is ready to read, that's my problem.
No, you're not such a bad guy after all. You can be nice if you want to be.
Guy, do I look like a guy to you?
Sorry, nice.
I tie rapper now, and that is why I tie rapper. I don't want anybody to regard me as guy.
Okay, nice man. Can I now assume that we are friends?
Friends? Why do you keep hammering on this friend? We walk the opposite sides of the street. We are a young girl who has finished university and is doing your service. I am a local man now. I have totally divorced myself from anything Oyibo. I'm living my life the way I want to live it because of what happened in the army. Tell me how these two people can, how can we relate as friends?
Oh, we can have good conversations, talk about different things. You can, you know, help me, you know, with things I'm focusing about the village, and I'll help you with the city.
What do you tell me about the city?
Uh-huh.
Is it because I'm tying this wrapper and dressing like this? You have forgotten that I came back from the city. I had been in the city for some time. What information can you tell me about the city that I don't already know? Okay, let me ask you honestly what I broke contact with information from in the city. One question. There is one program. Ichoku. Do they still televise it? The one that contains Lomaji Ugoji. Those are the things I want you will help me to talk.
Lomaji Ugoji. Who's that?
Hey! And you said you're going to give me information about the city.
Because I failed one question. Ask me another one.
There is none that I will ask you that you can answer. Fine, let me leave that branch. Let me come to sports. Etimesi. Is he still playing for Nigeria?
I don't know if he still plays, but I know him.
You don't know him?
I know him. He's one of the greatest footballers this country ever had.
When I said play, you automatically know that it is football. So don't bring that trick. You think you're smart? See, the information I want to ask you about city, you don't know it. So why are you thinking that you are going to give me information with cross-pollinate information? It will not work. This man that is sitting here has been in foreign cities, because I was there when during the Supreme Military Council when they were creating states. I was there when they were even drafting our constitution, so I know about the city and even forming of the city. You understand what I'm saying? He's even do what you do, this thing you do, what do we call it here?
National Youth Service Corps,
NYSC. I was there. I followed my adjutant the day they were drafting the National Youth Service or something. I normally go with my ogre. We go even the Supreme Military Council when they're having their meeting. They say, so, anything about the city, I know. There's none you cannot tell me. I know about the information of what you are doing.
So you know what's happening. You know what time it is.
Of course.
You see, that is why your heart belongs in the city. You belong in the city. Why don't you just, you know, sign these papers, give us permission to use your picture. The government will reward you with a bungalow in the city and the rent paid for 5 years, and then set up a small business for you. I'll be rewarded with, you know, the prize for the best youth corps member of the year. We'll both be happy. We'll remain friends. Even the farmers in this village, they will benefit a lot. When the calendar is sold, government will use it to buy fertilizers for them, which will be subsidized. They will pay less for it when they want to buy. Please, just give us permission to...
So, all this running around is for me to give you my picture. Being friends, cross-pollination of information. It's just for me to give you my photo.
If you don't give your permission, they will say I failed in my assignment.
Man, you're talking. You should have come straight instead of going telling me we move information, I will be friends and all that. This is the main objective for me to give you permission for my photo.
Okay. Welcome.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. Them in my house, under my roof. Look at my So you had the infantry to come to my house and then be strolling out of my parlor like Utobo and then telling me good afternoon, sir.
Uncle, what have I done again now? Eh?
What you have done?
Well, you were here when auntie said I can come to the house and see her.
I'm shouting. And auntie told you. Which auntie?
We weren't doing anything. We were just inside her room, chilling out, that's all.
Chilling out?
Yes.
Chilling out under my roof. You are in her room. Try to catch him and go out. So they have started chilling you out for you to chill them in. So under my roof, you people are chilling out and in. With bravado, Bemo.
No. Uncle, it's not like that, oh.
No, but you were here when Auntie Sam said I can come to the house. Instead of seeing her outside, I'll come to the house and see her. Then I'm shouting. You see the mother? She gave you permission to come and chill my daughter out.
You,
to come and watch for me.
Look at you. You are saying, be careful. Idiot. Next time, let me see you in my house.
Matolocha, and you? You?
We're just inside, or nothing happening there.
You want to get pregnant? Who knows the number of chilled meats that you have inside your stomach now?
We're not doing anything. We're
just sitting inside your room. Not even to live in the parlor. Look at you. Only to be a button. Why are all your buttons broken?
This is how it is.
That's how it is. Do you want to get pregnant? You can't, because you have been shouting from day one that you need sex. Ojibia, 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 you need sex. That's what you have been shouting. And now, under my roof.
No, you won't go.
Stop it! Stop it! Do you want to kill your child? You want to kill your own daughter?
We do it.
Uncle, did she lie? Please tell me the truth. Are you my father? Please, you need to tell me the truth. Are you my biological father? Who am I? Who are you to me? Whose child am I? The engineer whose wife maltreated me in the city, or you? Please tell me. Please.
She spoke the truth. I'm your biological father.
But I don't understand it. My mother is your sister. So how is it possible?
Uncle, you have to tell me. No. You're not going anywhere. No. You have to tell me who my father is now. I want to know. I want to know how. I want to know how How, please?
Alright. You want to know?
Yes.
Your late mother is my wife. I married her while I was in the army. We were living together until the army discharged me or dismissed me. I came back to the village with your mother and you. That's why we were in the village. Your mother met an engineer. They came for a water project in the village. And they ran away with him, taking you along. Well, unfortunately, your mother died. And the engineer remarried. That was the woman who was maltreating you in the city. I got wind of what was happening there, the maltreatment she was giving to you. So I went to the city to bring you back. That was how you came back to the village and started staying with me. Everybody in the village know what happened, the story. But I decided to hide it from you because of I didn't want you to go through the emotional trauma. And I'm sorry, I thought I would have told you at a better time. But unfortunately, you had to find out the way you found out. Your mother was a beautiful woman, but very promiscuous. See, that was why each time I see you talking about men or getting close to men, that fear comes in me. I try to protect you so that you don't follow the footsteps of your late mother. I'm sorry.
Jesus!
I don't want you to follow her footsteps.
I'm sorry, G. I'm really sorry.
Have you seen what you have caused? Are you happy now? Are you happy that you are about to, or you have destroyed my family? You can now gloat. Let me tell you. Before noon tomorrow, I do not want to see you or anything like you, or anything like any property that belongs to you in this my compound, or else.
You really have to stop threatening me, you know. What is wrong with a young girl falling in love? You, as her father, you should guide her instead of criticizing her. Okay, it slipped my tongue and I told her her true parentage. But I've done you a favor. I've taken the burden of telling her in the best way off from your neck. And as for you threatening me to leave tomorrow, it's not even 12 noon yet. I'm leaving immediately. She deserves to know who she is, who she really is to you. You can choose to love her and care for her or give her the roots that she needs to stand. Or you continue to be overbearing and abuse her. Okay, but one day she will look you in the eye and tell you what a bum you have been. A bum man who lived a bum life, carried her into a bum existence, refused to embrace positive change and give her the change that she needs when he had the chance.
You know I don't blame you.
Oh my God.
I was the person who gave you the chance. Oh nobody here God. Tells me how to live my life. Nobody tells me this is my village, it is my life. You have come to ruin it.
See, I'm really sorry. But if you ever need to leave this man here and come to the city, ask for Ejinaka Local Government Secretariat. Ask for Youth Corps member Samantha. Everyone knows me there. Okay? Knowing the kind of man that he is, he won't even give you money for soap. This is for your soap and toiletries. It's 10,000 naira. I'm sorry. Manage it. I have to go. If not, I'll kill him or he'll kill me. I'm really sorry.
Keep your money. Nobody needs your money. Give her the money back. Come and take your money. Nobody wants your 10,000.
Jesus. Jesus. No, no. To get away from here. I just want to go to a place where I can get fresh air. Somewhere different from this place. Away from all this that has been happening. Listen, I just want to make a future for myself. My uncle said I cannot go to the city except I pass my JAMB examination and then go to the university. So tell me now, how will I live with him when I know he doesn't like me? He hates me for what my mother did to him. How can I stay in the same house with him?
It's okay, alright? It's okay. I mean, you have me. And I have you. That's the most important thing. Alright? I mean, let's take it one at a time. Carry on. Smile for me, okay? At least I'm here with you, my
God. You don't have to lose hope, even when there is no hope. It can't pull again, no biggie. Makani magi echigabo. Never you give up, even when there is hold up. There is hope, as long as there is life. There is hope, whether in the village, there is hope. There is hope. In the city, wherever you are. There is hope, whatever you do. There is hope, never you give up. There is hope. Oh, 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 oh. When God decides to remember you, he can pass through anything. Your stubbornness could bring you to where you think you will never
be. Yes. How can you be asking me for a kiss at this time in my life? This lowest point of my life. Mojo!
Come! Jessica, this is where you are. This early morning. Huh? You are stamping your feet on the ground for me. I have gone to the army. Where have you gone? Huh? You know how much I hate this earth. Whose only objective is to have access to your thighs and probably tear your cleavage to shreds. And I run away.
Sir, Uncle Wanko, you have no right to say such things about me. You have no right at all. You denying father.
No, no, no. Stay away from me. Let me tell you how much of a denying father I am. Let me tell you how much of... In fact, I will vent my spleen on you and you will know. Look at you. Instead of doing something useful with your life, following your granny to your grandmother to the farm. No, you want to farm on top of my daughter. I'm telling you.
See, it's not because I'm running away from you. Look, I'm not a local champion like you, let me tell you. See, don't push me this man. If you push me, I'll make you vanish from this village. Ah, what's that?
You're not a local champion like
me. Yes.
You. You're international champion. Yeah? You're international. Work for me! Two alternatives. It's either you go back to the city and begin to dance the Awantiro you have been dancing there. Or if you choose to stay in this village and not comport yourself, I will kill you with my own hands. It's a promise and a tipa. Look at you. You are not a local man. You are international. International puppy dog. Get on your chair. And you. Let me make it very clear. I have vowed nobody close to me again is going to run to the city with a man. Ajulu me ajulu. Do you understand? I said no to it. Look at you. And you are talking from a distance. I thought as a man you should have come back.
instead of you helping your grandmother to farm and make good use of your life, you want to do your own farming on my daughter. It's not going to happen. And I won't let it happen.
Una. Come on. Una! Come on, get home. You are coming. Look at the hungry thing that we have gone to. Because that thing in budging in his pocket cannot be something useful. This kind of nonsense do not, instead of you getting close to somebody who is useful, who has been useful, none in this very village. You went and then get close to an imported Ukitocha. You don't have ambition. You. I don't blame you. You have a free, a very free ties. I got to go free. Next time this kind of a thing repeats itself, I will divorce your head from your body. Thank you for you. Come here. Come, wait for me there. I said I'm in the lab.
You failed again?
I did my best, sir. I'm sorry.
I am totally disappointed in you. I would have sworn that no other person could have done this better than you. This little assignment. Anyway, there's no recommendation for you, and certainly no awards.
Yes, sir.
Come in.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, it looks like our friend in Udenu village has been upped among his children. A young man in that village on holiday came today at the police station to report that Mwankwo has been pursuing him with a cutlass, threatening to kill him if he ever stepped foot in that village again.
The same Mwankwo?
Yes, sir.
What about the boy that came to make the reports?
He has gone back to the village. I asked him to leave immediately so that Mwankwo will not have the slightest suspicions he came here. And I suggest we make an early morning arrest. That is, if you agree with me, sir.
Exactly what I was going to say. I want him arrested first thing tomorrow morning. Our men must leave as early as 4 a.m. in the morning to catch up with him while he's still asleep in bed. I think it's time for us to put him to order. I have changed my mind. Sometimes force is the best method when dealing with an animal. Diplomacy, you know, is for human beings, not for animals.
Well, well, well. Miss Amata,
sir,
you can go home. You've done your best, I guess. Maybe I underestimated the stubbornness of that bushman. We will lock him up.
Yes, sir.
So, I...
fresh trouble. They're coming here to arrest you.
Listen, did I not tell you not to show your face around this visit again? You thought I was joking?
Why don't you just listen to me, Mr. Wanko? We may not be best of friends, but I know you and Chiadika too well to bear seeing you in jail, okay? There's fresh trouble. The local government police is coming here as early as 7 a.m. to arrest you.
What kind of fresh trouble? What did they say he did?
I think that boy King, he came to town to report to the police that your father wants to kill him and has been pursuing him around the village with a cutlass. So they'll be here as early as 7 a.m. You just have to leave. If you have to spend the night here, you have to leave before 7 a.m. Okay?
So, that boy has the audacity to go to the town and report me to the police.
Which is, are you staying or you're leaving?
Like you're coming back from the city.
Oh, yes, I'm just coming from the city.
So, what did you do next?
Well, I went to the police. I had to protect my life first. Then I told them about your father's threat to kill me.
Ah, so it's true. So you went to report my father to the police. This boy, you're wicked though. It is King. You're very, very wicked. Very wicked.
What do you mean I'm very wicked? I mean, do you want your father to come in here and kill me without anybody deterring him?
But it was just a domestic issue. You did not need to report him at the police station now. Eh? Okay, tell me. How will I love you knowing that my father is being locked up there? How will I love you?
Chiadika, my life is not a domestic issue. My life is precious to me, even if it's not to you.
Eh?
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I will not see you again. Don't come near me again. Stay on your own. Stay on your own.
Fine, no problem. Yeah, if you say so.
Eh?
Hmm?
Fine.
Fine.
Huh. Hey, my father told me, that you're no good for me, but I did not believe him. Hey, you know what? I know I'll find love someday.
Fine, no problem. Is that what you want? No problem. Yeah. I mean, it wasn't as if I got any nookies from you. It was always, no, not time, I don't have the time, no, no, I'm not in the mood, I don't want this, I don't want that. I'm starving. I better go back to the city where I can get some red-blooded chicks I can roll around with. Instead of staying here, having high hopes on you. Getting cock and bull stories all the time.
That's what you're saying, Abby.
Yes.
That's what you're saying.
Ciao.
Tell him that we are not living here without him. We shall be here and await his return. We are stocked in supplies. We are going nowhere until we arrest him.
We can't go anywhere.
Take your camps.
Did you say anything about me? Because I deliberately left my car there so that they will know that I'm the one that came to warn Wanko. I don't agree with this arrest method.
He didn't say anything about you. But he just said that they are prepared to wait till any time he comes out from his hiding. But my place is very small, in case if you need a place to pass the night. Just come over.
Don't mind them. They are just talking. We'll leave before nightfall.
We wait here now. We wait till nightfall.
Uncle, are we going to pass the night here? Why don't we go to that your friend's house, the one that came here in the morning and said that we should pass the night?
That's the wrongest place for us to go. Don't you know that these people will be watching my close relations and their friends? They'll be watching them very, very closely. It will be a very big risk for me to go just to your parents. I'm even thinking of Ikunem as my mother's place that is my hibut. I rented my hibut to Kalia in the home village.
How far?
Not so far, but very, very safe. Let us go to Kalia.
Welcome.
Tell me that this your goat is worth 2,000 naira per week.
I have paid for 2 weeks. I gave your daughter 2,000 naira the other day. Did she give it to you?
Akukalo, I said that the services of my goat has increased. It has increased. We are removing the subsidy. Listen, I have been subsidizing it on the waste of your Igushi goat. I have removed it. I charge now 2,000 naira per week because it's doing more than even.
No.
You can't tell me that, Uncle. Why are you too hard on this your business, Uncle? Why don't you allow your one penny to fall into another person's hand? I have heard you last night with your family, knowing fully well that you have a police case, and that they can even come here and arrest me as an accomplice for aborting you. What is greater, what is more than that, Uncle? What is greater than that? Why are you insisting on collecting your last kobo from me for the service of this your ego? Why, Wango?
So, Akukalia, are you telling me that you are now charging my 1 year to refer to you for staying, for harboring me? And Akukalia, this is a family, this is a community, and you know what you do for us. If there is fire in one person's heart, you know all of us are going to quench that very fire. Do we charge the person? Even a million people. That's why we are staying in this area. Now you are charging me for staying in your place. So this is a hotel now. Hotel de Akukalia. No. Hotel de Akukalia, then fine. I will accept it. Let all the money I'm owing you take it from the services of this inn. I know that she has serviced you and your goat very well. Take it. No problem. Akukalia, I'm not going to work that you have of me.
So we are going.
Wow. We can no longer pay for hotel de Akukalia.
Wow.
No more!
What is the matter?
Akukalia said, Nami Sabi. Nami Sabi. Because I tried to take the money for renting my goat here. Akukalia man is charging me for harboring me, us, one day. Akukalia want to take that. I asked Akukalia, Akukalia says, Nami Sabi.
So we're going. Okay, why don't you just give me permission to use your picture? I will use it to bargain for your freedom.
Why are you still talking about this picture? Are we still talking about it?
Yes, we are. Just give me your permission. Please.
Father, please, I don't want them to lock you up in that place. Just give them the permission to use your picture for that almanac. I just found out you're my father. I don't want to lose you. Just please. How do you think I'll feel knowing that you're going to be in that prison for God knows how long? I'm going to go through so much pain. Father, please, if you're not thinking about yourself, think about me. How will I stay alone in this village?
I'm doing this for my daughter, not for the government.
Okay.
I'm doing this partly for my daughter, partly for you.
Thank you.
Fine, you can use the picture.
Okay, fantastic, yeah. Good.
But I have a better idea.
Oh, okay.
Because I know my goat knows me, we are poor together. Mm-hmm. So we can give you a better pose than that thing that you
okay, so what idea do you have?
Um,
is a teacher. Ask this man if he can rent us good, because I don't want to borrow things from him. He'll always charge you. If he can give us two ties, then I'll give you better clothes.
Please, Mr. Kukala, do you have perhaps two matching ties or closely matched ties that we could borrow? Okay, we'll pay you for it.
Of course. I don't need your money. Huh? If it is, if that is what you need, I'll give it to you.
Thank you.
I don't need your money.
Thank you.
We have been paying you for everything.
Okay, good, good. This is really good.
We have been paying you.
Thank you so much.
So what I want to do this is
okay.
So that myself and so me and Chaplin will be doing anything you want.
You don't have to lose it.
I have the professional
ability. There is no hope. It can't pull again. No
good. I can't
never you give up. Even when there is hold up, come what may, there is hope. As long as there is life. Your stubbornness could bring you to where you think you will never reach. God might even get you a friend who could lead you to your destiny. Do not judge the present with the past, because it's God that holds your future.
Oh. There is hope
anywhere you are.
There is hope.
So, my men have just arrived with Mr. Mwango. After spending a night in that village, they arrested him alongside the female cult member whom you sent earlier on assignment to get his approval for the picture we wanted to use for our Almana project. She has gone earlier to warn him. My men reached there, they didn't see anybody. Surprisingly, this morning, they all came back, surrendered, the man, Samantha, and his daughter. Bring them in immediately. They are outside with the security man. 1 minute, sir.
Where is Samantha?
Good afternoon.
She had gone to the disciplinary committee to obtain a clearance.
So, you are the Mwango?
Yes, I am the Mwango, like you put it. I was persuaded by my daughter and Samantha that I should give approval for those pictures. In fact, my daughter Chadika took some other pictures. You know, show them. You see, my daughter Chadika took all of them. They are fantastic.
This is fantastic.
That's what I've been saying.
It's even better than the one we had before.
Exactly.
What about the release paper?
Okay, the paper they gave me. I told them that there was no need for this. I gave it with all my heart. There was no point signing approval or release. You can take it to do anything with it.
Good, good, good. You have even signed for us to use the almanac. Mr. Luke,
sir.
This man is free.
Sir, just like that?
Yes. There shall be no further harassment on this man.
And I'm wondering why he's even there. After all, even your boys were so cooperative. When we surrendered ourselves, they even allowed us to go and change our dress. Why are you saying just like that?
The promise of a bungalow for 5 years and the cash reward of 1 million naira will be made available for him to start a little business.
Sir,
please,
you're free.
Now that I have given you the approval, can I go?
Yes, you will go. But before then, please, I would like to show you the bungalow We have rented for you for 5 years.
I came here unwillingly because of the cooperation that we have been given and receiving. Said, take this. Why should I now take your house? Neither do I need the money that you need. If you people say you are bringing development, or that my picture on the almanac will bring development to my community, I'm all for it. I will even receive kudos for it from the members of the village, of the community. Since it is going to bring development like you promised, unless you people have other things in mind not to bring the development. Because if the development is coming, and they said it's because of the my picture on the almanac, the credit is not going to me. Because now if I take the money, it means I've been bribed. If you people backslide on your promise, or take your house, the government have bribed him. So, sir, it won't be well with my conscience. I would like to go back, keep whatever, provided you promise in the Makachiadika. Provided you do it, take the thing free. I'm not accepting anything, sir. I just want to go back.
Well then, let him go. I'll personally arrange my driver to take them back to the village. Peradventure he decides to change his mind for our offer, it will be made available to him in a true club and I. Please, get them released at the police station.
I will free now, I will release now, sir.
And take this picture and download it.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Why do you feel my just about this? Do you okay say that you should believe? And you say what for?
Chadika!
Yes, Papa!
Your friend is here.
Hey, sir.
How are you?
Auntie Samantha, you're welcome.
You're doing makeup, eh? How are you?
I'm fine. I thought you forgot about.
How can I forget you or your daddy? Is it possible? God forbid.
Good afternoon, sir.
Welcome.
Good afternoon.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're looking good.
Thanks. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Just the way you left me. Mm-hmm. Still doing my farm work, trying to make ends meet, and still renting my one champion he-goat.
Mm.
You know that he-goat is something now? That it's in folk. In fact, my he-goat is in folk. I'm sure, but be very popular among the sheep around this village.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, you brought another fertilizer.
Yes.
How much is this one going to be this time? I know it's a cutthroat since things are changing.
Well, it will surprise you. It was for this that you came.
What of that, the almanac project?
Like I said, it's for that reason that we came today. The local government chairman asked me to greet you. He sends his warm regards.
Oh, wow.
He holds you in high esteem. Yes. This time the fertilizers are free for the whole community.
Free?
Free, child. You don't have to pay anything for it. All you need to do is gather strong young boys to upload the fertilizer and you distribute it to the village free of charge. The local government chairman told me to tell you that this time he's giving you a job. Because he believes in your person. He believes you are the only person that can supervise the equitable distribution of the fertilizer to the whole communities in this village. And that is not a small thing. You see, he trusts and believes in you. Please, he is ready to pay you 75,000 naira per month for the next 8 years while he is in his 2-year terms as the local government chairman.
Before you say anything, Wankwo, this is not free money. It is a job.
And if you refuse it, that means you have not served your people. And it also means that you do not have the interests of the farmers at heart. If you reject this job, another will take it and might possibly cheat your people. I know that's not what you want.
And Mr. Wako, we don't want you to take this job free. If you take it free, there will not be commitment and we will not be able to hold you in case the sharing fails. If you refuse the job, some other person will take it, will be employed to take it. And that's not exactly what the local government chairman wants. He believes in your person. He believes that you are the only person that can supervise the equitable distribution of the fertilizers throughout the whole village. And please, see this as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to serve your people, the people that you love so much. Mr. Wang, but we look for another person.
For the sake of my people, I will accept the job.
Oh, that's good. At least now you can easily finance your daughter's university education.
Yes, yes.
That's all our money.
Auntie Samantha, thank you so much. I know you must have talked to the local government chairman into my father's
school. No, I didn't have to do much. The local government chairman saw your father's integrity with his own eyes. So, I mean, convincing him wasn't that difficult. Marco, let me make this personal confession. If you were educated, a lot younger, and willing to live in the city, and I find a man like you, I would propose without a second's hesitation. I came very, very close to falling in love with you. This close. But since you and I are evenly yoked, marriage cannot happen. Despite these obvious reasons, I think you are indeed a lovable man, despite your cantankerous nature, full of bravery and integrity, and a man any woman can count on. I pray that you find a wife who will really love you and take away the pains that your first wife caused. I also pray that you find it in your heart to forgive her so that her soul can rest in peace.
Sam, actually, I don't know. I don't know how to explain the kind of feelings I have. But I know I have good feelings inside me. But since I can't explain it, I did before. But maybe God will help me and help me to forget. You know. I wish things were different. Honestly, we would have been singing another tune now. You understand? But I wish you well, Mario, because God will guide you and lead you wherever you have a project you want to.
Thank you. One more favor. Can Chanika please come with me and live with me in the city? I'll make sure she reads her books, she'll attend lectures, and then she will sit for her university examination.
You want to go to the city, please? Alright. No, there's a condition attached there. On the condition that you have to be coming home frequently to see me.
Oh, we will come together.